These are the top five chemicals that professionals use in their pressure washing business. Hey, I'm Jeremy with Kentucky Wash Pros, and I want to share these chemicals that has helped me make thousands of dollars. All right, first up, I want to talk to you about is EcoChem One Restore. I like to buy this in the 5 gallon pails, 5 gallon buckets. I like to have it readily available. I like to have a lot on hand because I never know what I'm going to get into. Now, EcoChem One Restore is an acid-based chemical. So it's really good for breaking down rust, whether that's like rust spots on driveways and concretes and patios you might find at a restaurant or in sidewalks from like new developments, new constructions, things going in. Also works really good for like say if you've got an air conditioner that's mounted on a house or an apartment building and it's got those rust stains coming down, or something coming from like a drain line from a chimney and it's coming down. This is your go-to right here. This One Restore, hands down, one of my absolute favorite chemicals to use. Now there's other brands out there as well, such as like F9 Bark, which is a really good one as well, but One Restore is readily available to where I'm at, so this is what I like to use, and I've just had fantastic results, so there's no point in switching when things are working. So I highly recommend you pick you up some of this. Pick it up in the bulk. It's always cheaper. The more you buy, the cheaper it is. It's a good investment, and 5 gallons will go a long way. You know, especially if you're not dealing with it every day, day in and day out, this will go a long, long way. Next up, I want to talk to you about is Cleans BC. Now, Cleans BC is also an EcoChem product. And I like to keep this on hand because this works really good for, you can use it on wood. It works on wood. But what I primarily like to use it for is vinyl siding. When you see those vinyl siding houses that's got heavy oxidation and stuff of that nature, and someone's wanting to do a restoration on a cleaning, like to get that taken off because they've tried to clean it themselves. If you see those tiger stripes, or not really tiger stripes, but just those wan marks where that's oxidation disturbed, EcoChem Cleansol BC is the product that's going to help you break that down. It's really good. It works really well on oxidation removal. It also works really well on tiger stripes for gutters. So if you've ever seen like oxidized gutters, you can use that as well, which leads me into another chemical, which is a gutter bright. This is just locally available. I picked this up on the cheap. Now, if I was going to go out and purchase some, I'd probably be looking more into a gutter butter, but I just needed one job and my Cleansol BC was out, so that's time to restock on that. So I picked this up and it worked fairly good. I'm not overly praising this brand per se, but a gutter brightener such as gutter butter is what I would recommend. Or there's a chemical I believe called gutter bright. I've heard really good things about it, but definitely something that will help increase your ticket is using these specialty chemicals. Gutter bright is a totally different sell on cleaning the house than just washing the house. It's an upsell. It's an upcharge. So the next chemical I'm going to talk to you about is a degreaser. Now, you don't really see any degreasers sitting up here. I have a 5 gallon pail over here, just some off brand that I picked up, and it works okay. But a trick that the professionals use that doesn't, you know, most people don't know about is what's inside this container here. Inside this container here is sodium hydroxide beads. Now, I picked this up in the 50 gallon containers. It comes in a bag. Sometimes you can find it in the container already, but I just picked up a cheap 5 gallon bucket, poured it over in there and sealed it up. Now this stuff is perfect for all your heavy degreasing, such as drive-throughs, sidewalks, high foot traffic areas, really anything with degreasing or degreaser. I mean, it can be oils, it can be hydraulic fluids. It's not gonna do like super crazy great on hydraulic fluids, but it's pretty good. But this is good for like factory washing, factory warehouses, like if you've got equipment you're trying to degrease. It's a really good additive, like if you picked up some of the purple Zep from a you know, Lowe's is pretty rarely available. The Purple Zep is not a bad degreaser, but if you can throw you a little bit of this powder, these beads inside on that, it's going to intensify it greatly. So this is kind of like most degreasers are sodium hydroxide based. So you're getting it straight from the source. So you can really determine your potency and your strength with this, but this is something that you have to be careful with because it can burn you chemically. So my recommendations are to mix this. You get your water first in your bucket. So I like to use, this is me personally, one cup per gallon. That's how I like to use it, and I'll downstream that. Now you can pump spray that, you can X-jet that. It's gonna be a little bit stronger if you're pump spraying or X-jetting it than it is downstreaming because it's getting diluted. But that's how we do it. We downstream it at one cup per gallon downstream when we clean our restaurants, and it just works phenomenally. But what I'm saying is, say you got 5 gallon water, you're gonna put 5 cups in. So you got your water first, then you put your cups in, and what that's gonna do is allow that not to splash up when the water's going in and you get a chemical burn. So when you put it in there, the water reactivates with the sodium hydroxide. So you wanna get you a drop stick or a piece of tubing or something, and you need to mix it up. Now, I highly recommend having your rubber boots on, rubber gloves on, and having a respirator and goggles. This stuff is potent. It's very potent. It'll take your breath. It'll give you a chemical burn. I'll see if I've got a picture from my ankle where I got burnt and inserted in here so you can see that. But this is no joke. So far we've talked about One Restore for rust, Cleanse All BC for oxidation. We've talked about the gutter brightening for gutter whitening. We've talked about the degreaser, sodium hydroxide for degreasing restaurants, equipment, stuff of that nature. So those are, in my opinion, some of the utmost specialty chems to keep on hand. I don't really like to run much surfactant, but when I do, I like to use SolManade. You can see that. That's from Southside Equipment. That's from Russ Johnson. There'll be a link in the description if you want to pick some of that up, but you can see this is in a 5 gallon pail, and this 5 gallons has lasted me a year and a half, 2 years. I'm not a big proponent on surfactant unless I'm doing like a crazy steep roof, like a 12-12 or greater pitch, then I will use some surfactant. I'm just not one of those guys who's a big believer in it. It has its purpose and it does work. I don't really care about the masking scent. That don't matter to me. 9 out of 10 times, people say, man, my house smells clean. I can smell they'll say, I can smell the Clorox or I can smell the chlorine. It smells good. So I've never really had anyone say anything negative about the smell of the sodium hypochlorite. But this is a pretty good smell. It's pretty good masking. It's got a lemon scent. I think you can get cherry as well. Highly recommend it. If I'm buying surfactant, then I'm buying SolManade. So one last specialty chemical that I want to talk to you about that can increase your ticket and help you get some other jobs is NMD80. This is an EcoChem product as well. This stuff is good for like post-construction. It's like a mortar cleaning. If you've ever noticed like the brick smear and stuff like that, like when they're doing like a new brick house or like a brick patio and it's just kind of smeared, this is the stuff you want to use to take that off. It won't damage it. You just got to know how to use it. There's some videos out there. I don't have any that I've showed, but I have used it. This is 1 gallon. This one, I think I've went through 1 other gallon and I picked this one up as a backup because it's not something that you're going to use all the time, but it's something that's there in your tool belt if you need it. So we just keep everything inside this garage. It is heat and air cooled, so it's our chemicals stay good because they're not really, it's a 70 degrees in here year round. So I would consider picking some of this up for no more than it's costing. Last time I bought it, I think it was like $28 a gallon. But that $28 can make you a whole lot of money. So guys, these are just a few of the special chemicals I wanted to talk to you about, things that I think that anyone should keep. Now, you don't have to have these brands per se, but I definitely recommend EcoChem. I'm a firm believer. I like their products and they work good. F9's a really good product. Craig Harrison's a great guy. He has, I just haven't really had the opportunity to buy those chemicals close to me to give a shot. So we just stick with what we have access to, and this is what we do. So guys, I hope this video has been helpful. If it has, do me a favor, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Let me know if there's any kind of chemicals that I miss or things that you may, that you might use that I don't use. I know one that I can think of is graffiti removal. That's a good upsell. We haven't really done any much of that where I live at. It's not really a lot of graffiti, but so that's an option. But anyways, I hope this is helpful. Hey, do me a favor. If you haven't already, you'll see here on the end card, either here or here, we got a podcast. So go ahead and check out the podcast if you don't mind. All right, guys. Appreciate you. Be strong. Wash on.